Welcome back, everyone. It's York Gibbs, and we're playing Nancy Drew. Haunted Carousel? Yes, I think that's what we're playing. This is the eighth game in the series. Why is it all spooky now? Oh, the rotating guy.
Hey, Nance. What's going on?
You just called me Nance. Wait a minute. I don't even know you. You're calling me Nance? Pretty soon you're going to be calling me Nan.
I'll let you get back to work.
Rock on.
Rock on indeed. So what do we have here? Adhesive, screws, bolts, hinges.
Could I have some of these tissue strips?
Be my guest.
Alright, let's gather up some tissue strips for some reason. Nancy just wants to carry them around for funsies? Is that kind of what we're doing here? Time for us to leave. Where shall we go? Let's go back here. Hi there.
Hey, Nancy, what's up?
I'll see you around.
Sounds good.
Okay, so he clearly is having a good day or whatever. He likes spinning around in his chair. Where can we go? Let's go talk to Ingrid. Ingrid.
Hello, Nancy. How goes it?
Thanks for your help.
No big deal.
Nobody wants to talk to me. Elliot, we were just there. Let's talk to Joy then. Hello?
Any luck with the riddle? I'm still working on it. Need something? I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks, Nancy.
I thought I solved the riddle in the last episode. Well, why don't we go to the hotel and maybe we can, I don't know, relax for a little bit. What do we have here? Journal. Tried to get inside the roller coaster to check out, but the access card reader was broken. That's right, we need to get a fun day. A keyboard, and we need to fix the barnacle blast. News from home. So, I'm not sure if it's my imagination, but it feels really...
Dear Ned, well, here I am at Captain's Cove Amusement Park.
I'm gonna put that music down just a little bit.
Hotel operator, what do you want?
Fun day, please.
I'd like to order a fun day, please.
2,480 calories worth of sheer heaven plus one official fun day serving this bone coming right up. Anything else?
No. That will do. That will totally do.
That's it. Thanks a lot.
Don't mention it.
Yummy. Hello? Ooh. The best fun day ever.
Oh, that was so good.
Hey, it's a spoon. Now we need that because we need to do something with that. That is the riddle. So we're going to go ahead and... I wonder if I can order another fun day because, you know.
Hotel operator, what do you want?
I'd like to order a fun day, please.
Yeah.
Another fun day, huh?
Another
Anything
fun
else?
Day. No, that'll do it.
That's it. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, sure, whatever.
I want all the fun days. Yum.
Mm.
Yes. Oh, I only get one spoon? Darn. Okay, well, let's go and solve that riddle before Nancy has any desires for another fun day. I don't think we needed this here, did we? No. We nearly got crushed by that roller coaster. The shark thing here. Leave Nancy's clothes all neatly folded there. Nancy, what are you doing in here? Oh, the ironing board. No. We don't want to burn the hotel down again. Okay, let's go. We want to go to Joy and say, here, I've got a spoon.
Any luck?
Sure thing.
I'm pretty sure Miles wants us to bring him the souvenir spoon you get when you order a fun day sundae at the captain's quarters. I have one right here.
Give it to Miles and see what happens.
Lay it on me.
Lay it on you? He's a little oven. Look at him. He's adorable.
The scan is complete. The object is correct. Your mother used to take you for a sundae at the captain's quarters almost every week. Do you remember, Joy?
The captain's quarters fun day. I do remember that. I was so small, I always had to sit on my mother's lap to eat it. I wish I could remember what she looked like.
Don't you have a picture of her?
You were very little when your mother died, Joy. Your grief came out as anger. Before your father could stop you, you destroyed every picture of your mother that he had.
I did that? No, my father told me he had gotten rid of them. He always said some things are better left forgotten. Oh my gosh, I'm the reason I have nothing to remember her by.
I'm sure your father helped you shut out the truth in order to spare your feelings.
The older your father got, Joy, the more he realized that life is nothing but memories. He realized that even bad memories have a place in a good life. That is why he invented
Miles the Magnificent Memory Machine!
Okay.
Here is the second riddle. This one is written down. Please remove it.
I will do that.
It's just a blank piece of paper.
You and your mother used to love to play this game, Joy.
What game? What game?
Once again, I have no idea what he's talking about.
Oh, I'm sure we'll figure it out.
You know, some of the things your father wants you to remember may be pretty painful. Are you sure you want to go on?
If you still want to help me, please, Nancy, keep going. I feel like a door somewhere is starting to creak open. I'm kind of scared to open it, but I also kind of know I have to.
Okay.
I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
Thanks, Nancy.
Wait, what was the riddle?
I really do need to get this work done.
Right. Sorry.
Okay. We have to figure out how... Maybe it's like a lemon juice thing, right? Where you add steam? That's gonna be my guess. And how are we gonna add steam? What object do we have that burned down the hotel that has steam? It was totally an accident. Wait, what? What are we doing? There we go. More, come on. Again.
The first 8 notes of your favorite band organ tune, plus 1 mouth organ, plus 1 smidgen of talent, equals 1 happy Miles.
Okay. Well, interesting. No. Nancy wants to put that away. Shut it off.
I need to turn the iron on.
No, I don't. I need to turn it off. Okay, so I have a riddle. Do. Maybe we just go give it back? I don't know, we'll try.
Any luck?
Yep.
There was a message written in lemon juice on that piece of paper Miles gave us. We're to play the first 8 notes of your favorite band organ tune on a mouth organ for Miles.
My favorite band organ tune? I don't even know what a band organ is. Or a mouth organ either, for that matter.
Harmonica.
I think a mouth organ is a harmonica.
Correct. The music you hear when you ride the Captain's Cove carousel comes from the band organ that sits inside the rider platform. You used to play the harmonica for your mother all the time, Joy. Your favorite tune was the one you heard on the carousel.
It couldn't have been. I never rode the carousel. I always thought it was stupid. I thought all the rides in the park were stupid.
Is that all you can tell us, Miles?
I have been programmed to give you one hint. The tune is on the third roll. You will have to think about this one. End of hint.
It's all yours, Detective.
Oh, no.
As usual, I'm stumped.
So, now what are we going to do?
I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
Thanks, Nancy.
I guess we're going to go to the carousel and see what's going on over there. Carousel. Can we just get in there? What do we have here? This is the evidence scene of the crime. Hello? Ooh, what's this?
This takes an employee access card.
Do I not have one of those? Yes, I do. Wow, we're inside. Cool. Oh, do we know this? I don't think we know that. The exit. I'm not sure what else we can do in here. Oh, what's this?
Time to start crawling. This goes to the space underneath the carousel.
Cool, cool. What is this?
Wonder what that is?
Some sort of remote.
If I don't move, I'm gonna get skewered.
Oh boy. That's pretty cool, actually. Nancy. Shish kebab Nancy.
There's something up there. Looks like a letter.
Where? Oh, I see. How do I...
I can't reach it.
Do we have anything that can? Screwdriver? Whoa! Okay. This is interesting.
The ballroom? That's what was converted into the haunted house.
1913, wow. The work goes slowly, but it goes. I just completed the fifth horse. My favorite so far. I call him Foxfire. Okay, every night music plays in the ballroom above my workshop. Every night 100 feet scamper back and forth. But you understand, my darling wife, you are the only person on earth who has ever understood everything that can be understood about me, and I miss you
terribly. Kessler's workshop would have been under what's now the haunted house. I wonder if it's still there.
The radiator still stands guard outside the door to my workshop, as cold and heavy as my heart, awaiting your return. You must come back to me. Your father was loath to give me your address. I promised him things will be better, as I now promise you, if, when you return. But what if you don't read this? What if it comes back unopened? Or worse, what if it never comes back, and neither do you? Your rejection would be unbearable. Perhaps I shall mail this letter tomorrow, but I know now that I cannot mail it today. My beloved, I don't have the courage. I cannot take the risk. I love you too much. So I really love the writing here. The font is... I wish I could write, or I guess print like that. Alright, so I've got myself a letter. That's cool. A little unexpected. I've got this tissue, which I don't even know it's... Okay, well, let's get out of here. How do I... Okay. Now I'm going against the horsies. Where is this organ? Wasn't there supposed to be an organ somewhere? Oh, what's this? Open, please. Aha!
Guess I'm gonna have to call Tink. whoever he is.
Tink. Okay, well, let's call him. Do we have a cell phone? Yes, we do. Directory. Sure, we'll call the police department.
Captain's Cove Police Station.
Detective Paris, please.
Hang on.
Hi, Nancy.
Hello, Detective Paris. You have caller ID?
Hey, just because we're small doesn't mean we're prehistoric. Afraid I don't have anything on Dunning yet. Still waiting for people to return my calls.
How much do you know about Daryl Trent? You know, the guy who used to be the co-owner of Captain's Cove, Paula's former business partner?
I met him a couple of times. Real friendly guy. Young at heart. More of a kid than most kids. I kind of think that's what killed him, you know? His body just got too old for his soul.
Did you ever meet his daughter?
I didn't even know she existed until Paula mentioned she'd hired her.
Thanks, Detective. You've been a big help.
Glad I could be of service.
How was that helpful? That didn't feel very helpful at all. Hardy Boys, home. Oh, you know what? It's time to call the ladies.
Hello?
Hey, Bess. It's Nancy.
Oh, hey, Nancy.
Wow.
Whoa, you were obviously hoping I was someone else.
Well, kinda.
Okay, so who is he and where'd you meet him?
Oh, Nancy, his name's Matt, and he is so cute. He works the concession stand at the movie theater in the mall. A cute guy with an endless supply of gummy bears and butter flavoring. Right at his fingertips. We're talking major crush.
Hey, George, good. You're there, too.
Barely. I almost got caught standing between Bess and the phone just now. When it rings, she's like a one-woman cattle stampede.
Okay.
What happened to caller ID, Bess?
My parents yanked it. She wouldn't pick up when it was some loser she didn't want to talk to. Her mother got tired of hearing the phone ring all the time.
Not all those calls were from losers. Sometimes I was playing hard to get. Anyway, how are things at the amusement park?
I met the security guard, Harlan Bishop. Nice guy. Except when I asked him where he worked before. He seemed kind of evasive.
Is he cute? Bess, what difference does that make?
Ugly people have chips on their shoulders and are more likely to commit crimes, George. I read that somewhere. Either read it or saw it on Oprah.
Okay.
He gave me a pass that lets me ride all the rides and play all the games on the Midway. Unfortunately, almost all the rides are closed.
Sounds like he could be trying to butter you up. And we know what that means, don't we, Bess?
Suspect list.
I think I might know why somebody stole that horse off the carousel. They were looking for jewels that had been hidden inside it after a hotel robbery.
Hidden jewels? I love it! That's almost as good as buried treasure!
But if they recovered the jewels, why is the carousel still going around by itself?
I'm not sure yet, but the detective who is in charge of investigating the robbery is helping me look into it.
Don't let George discourage you, Nancy. I, for one, think you're on the right track. You can never go wrong when jewelry is involved.
Fair enough.
There was a brochure for a sports car in Ingrid's work area, the Pandora 2XS.
That is like the hottest car ever.
One of the most expensive, that's for sure. She must make a ton of money.
Either that or she's about to come into a ton of money.
The engine oil thickens.
What? The engine oil thickens?
I need you guys to do something for me. I found some stenography notes that I'd really like to translate, only I don't know shorthand.
Say no more. We'll do some research and get right back to you.
We will? I barely know how to spell stenography, let alone research it.
We'll call you when we're through. We can do this, Bess.
What is with all this wee stuff?
I finally met the park's art director, Elliot Chen. We kind of got off on the wrong foot, but he's real friendly to me now.
But is he too friendly? That's the question.
Yeah, maybe he's trying to deflect suspicion by making nice.
Maybe.
That could be. I do get the feeling he knows more about the carousel than he lets on.
Uh-oh. Sounds like another candidate for the
suspect list.
I almost got creamed by the roller coaster when I was on the tracks looking around, and I don't think it was an accident.
Someone tried to kill you? Ouch!
I found one of Joy's chewed-up pencils just before it happened, but she says she doesn't know how it got there.
Just from now on, stay away from that coaster, Nan. Stick to the carousel. Man, I never thought I'd hear myself say that.
I found a very odd-looking device under the carousel. I'm willing to bet that it's the reason the carousel seems to be turning on and off by itself.
So whoever put it there must know a lot about electronics.
Like that chief engineer person, maybe? She'd be my next stop.
Maybe.
I found a letter written by Rolf Kessler to his wife, Amelia. It was hidden inside the carousel.
A hidden love letter? That's so romantic. What did it say?
Well, apparently she'd left him, and he was begging her to come back.
Wait a minute. If the letter was to her, why was it inside the carousel?
Because he never sent it. He was too scared that she'd reject him. So he hid the letter inside the carousel, hoping someday he'd have enough guts to send it.
But he never did. Oh my gosh, romantic and tragic.
Aw. Very much. I guess it could have been a rom-com, but it's not.
In the letter, he mentioned that his workshop was under the ballroom, which is now the haunted house.
Do you think the workshop is still there?
You can bet I'm going to look.
Maybe Kessler's still there, too. Maybe he's like the phantom of the amusement park. 100-year-old phantom? I'm sure, Bess.
I found out that after Joy's mother died, she was so distraught that she destroyed every single picture of her mother that her father had.
Yikes, that's a little twisted.
The really weird thing is that she'd completely blocked it out of her memory. She thought her father had destroyed all the pictures.
Sounds like she could use a good shrink. I'd leave her on your suspect list, that's for sure.
The suspect list is growing and growing. It should be shrinking, but it's not.
To solve the second riddle, the one that was written in lemon juice, I have to play Joy's favorite tune from the carousel on a harmonica.
So what's her favorite tune?
Well, that's kind of the problem.
Let me guess. Little Miss Headcase can't remember.
Yep.
It's like she's built this wall between herself and her past. What I can't figure out is why.
Just be careful, Nan. This lady sounds none too stable.
Yeah, she sounds like old dynamite. One false move and kaboom!
What? Oh, the humor in this game is too much fun.
Got anything for me in the way of hints?
Yeah, call the Hardy Boys.
They'd never admit it, but I don't think they're doing much these days.
Call the Hardy Boys. All right, folks, well, we're out of time. We're going to have to do Call the Hardy Boys in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. We'll see you next time.